The way your sled handles itself on or off the trails is a different preference for every rider. The main goal is to find the right amount of weight transfer from the front or rear of the sled. This is the first and most important factor to consider when making adjustments to improve handling. Remember though that there will always be trade-offs to adjusting. Think of your sled on a teetering scale. The more we bias weight toward one end, the more the effects of the other end are reduced. Also remember to keep in mind that the snow conditions will be a major factor in how the sled handles. Now, there are many different scenarios you may encounter that would justify a suspension adjustment. It's important to understand what these scenarios are so you can recognize them when they happen and take the appropriate steps to resolve them. Oversteer is a condition where the sled will turn aggressively with little steering input. Typically, the back end of the sled will slide to the outside of the turn. To reduce oversteer, we need to increase the weight transfer to the rear of the sled. There are a few adjustments that can be done to do this. The first adjustment you'll want to make is to decrease the torsion spring preload. This will transfer more weight to the rear of the sled and lighten up the steering. This adjustment can be performed by using the spark plug socket included with your sled. Simply install the end of the socket onto the adjustment nut and turn to your desired setting. Always remember to adjust only one position at a time, moving from high to medium to low, and test drive before proceeding. This will transfer more weight to the rear of the sled and lighten up the steering. If you're still experiencing oversteer, you'll want to continue by increasing the front track spring preload. To do this, turn the spring adjuster on the front track shock clockwise until you have reduced the spring length by 1/8 inch. You should notice that the steering has gotten lighter and that the rear of the sled doesn't kick out as easily. If that doesn't help your condition, you can also increase the preload of the IFS springs. This can be done by turning the shock collar clockwise. Always perform this adjustment in 1/8 inch increments while the skis are off the ground and test drive your sled to see if the condition has improved. If you are still experiencing an oversteer condition on your sled, the last option would be to install a dual runner SKAG, which can be purchased at your local Polaris dealer or at polaris.com. Understeer is the opposite of oversteer, meaning that the sled is pushing through the snow when attempting to turn. We would combat this in the exact opposite manner by decreasing the weight transfer of the sled to the rear. The first step would be to increase the torsion spring preload using the spark plug socket included with your sled and test drive to see if the understeer has improved. Adjust only one notch at a time, moving from low to medium to high. The next adjustment we would make to reduce understeer would be to decrease preload on the front track spring. If this doesn't help, we would then decrease the preload on both IFS springs as a final adjustment. Ensure the skis are off the ground before adjusting the front IFS springs. Keep in mind that these adjustments could contribute to heavier steering. Understeer can also be a symptom of worn skags, so be sure to inspect your skags for worn carbides and replace them if needed. Another handling condition that you may encounter is darting. This happens when the sled grabs ruts in the trail and turns in a way that was not intended. In this scenario, the first thing we want to do is to make sure the skis are properly aligned before proceeding with any adjustments. Follow the procedures in your owner's manual to check and adjust ski alignment. Once you have verified proper ski alignment, we can start by increasing the preload to the front track spring. This will increase the weight transfer to the rear of the sled. This may also cause the sled to push or understeer, so it's important to find a nice middle ground. We can also combat this by installing a dual runner SKAG, which can be purchased at your local Polaris dealer or polaris.com. The last condition we're going to cover is ski lift. Ski lift is when the skis lift off the ground during acceleration, resulting in a loss of steering control. The best way to combat this is to decrease the preload on the front track spring. If this isn't able to correct your ski lift, continue by decreasing the preload on both IFS springs. Remember to adjust both sides equally at the same time. Turning up the rear coupling blocks will also help reduce ski lift. As a final reminder, always remember to mark down your adjustment points for reference in the future. For more information on your suspension settings, refer to your owner's manual or check out our Help Center article on suspension settings.